In this video, I'm going to demonstrate user remediation in hybrid environments by using Microsoft Defender for Identity. Today, work is hybrid, and so is the infrastructure supporting it. Your organization uses Azure Active Directory for identity in the cloud and Active Directory on-premises. Keeping the two synchronized can be challenging, especially when you take remediation action. So, we're considering every facet of an identity when you mark a user as compromised. We're focused on comprehensiveness and efficiency, so you only have to perform an action once. Here's how user remediation works. In Microsoft 365 Defender, you can act on a user in a few places, including a user entity page or advanced hunting. That action goes to Active Directory via the Defender for Identity Gateway and is logged in the Unified Action Center. Then, the next time Azure AD Connect synchronizes, that action is reflected in Azure AD. How long this takes depends on how often this sync happens, 30 minutes on average. Let's make this real, starting with an incident that impacts a user account. On the Alerts tab, I see that a user clicked on a malicious URL in an email message. Diving into that alert and looking at the full story, it's clear that this link is malicious. Until I investigate this further, I'd like to disable this account to prevent malware from running reconnaissance tools or moving laterally. I do that on the user page, which I can get to quickly by selecting Open User Page on the user card at the top of the alert. There are several actions available to me on the user page. For example, I can force a password reset. But what I really want to do is disable the user until I've got this incident contained. To do that, just select Disable User and confirm the action. As a result, Defender for Identity will disable the user account in Active Directory immediately, and Azure AD Connect will synchronize this action soon after. Now when I view the user in Microsoft 365 Defender, I clearly see that the user is disabled. The user account is also disabled in Active Directory, and my activity was logged in the Action Center. I was able to act once on the account, but see that change in both places. The user page isn't the only place you can take remediation action, by the way. For example, you can also do it in Advanced Hunting. Select a user account in the results set, and then select Take Actions. In addition to marking the user as compromised or forcing a password reset, you see the option to disable the user account. Select Disable User, and on the next page, select the on-premises SID of the account or accounts you're disabling. Hybrid remediation requires that you add an action account to Defender for Identity. This is a Group Managed Service Account, or GMSA, which is a domain account that provides automated password management and more over multiple servers. You learn all about action accounts in the article titled Microsoft Defender for Identity Action Accounts, including detailed step-by-step instructions for creating the GMSA. After creating the account, adding it to Defender for Identity is simple. On the Settings page, select Identities, then select Manage Action Accounts, and select Create New Account. Then, you provide the account name and the domain. A password is not required for a GMSA. With Defender for Identity, act once to remediate a user account in both Azure AD and Active Directory. To learn more about hybrid remediation in Defender for Identity, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs. Microsoft Security.